So we're up to our first basic clipping exercise. So we're going to do the install of the first fix, requiring us to install the plastic accessories onto a wooden board. But before doing so, we're going to need to facilitate the hole in the top of the box. As you can see, this one's already come out of stores with a hole in it. We don't believe that the IP rating of 4X on the top of that would be acceptable with the size of cable going into the hole. So I'm going to show us how to get a better fit for the cable before we have to fill it with a silicone sealant. So let's see how we're going to put the hole in the top of this box. Often on site then to remove the plastic area in the top or bottom or side of a box, we take a pair of pliers, we grasp onto the plastic which is already pre-broken into position, and then we knock out our hole. So that's a nasty, great big hole either in the top or side or bottom of the box, which will never get back to the correct IP rating, either 4X on the top surface or 2X on the remaining surfaces. So obviously there must be a better way of making the hole in the box to facilitate the cable. And let's see how we're going to do that. In order that we're going to cut out a hole that will be a reasonable size in order to facilitate, in this case, a 1mm² cable, but doesn't leave too much room, because obviously we're going to need to reinstate the IP rating using a silicone sealant, I'm going to cut out down there, and then break off gently with my pair of pliers the top lip, and then file it out using a needle file. Okay, so it's nice and smooth. So let's see how we're going to do that. Take my junior hacksaw. Gently run down the inside of that line on both sides. Okay, I haven't gone fully down. It could go a little bit further down than that, but I know I've only got a 1mm cable in order to go into the top of the box. I take my pliers and I'm going to position them just to break out that section. Okay, I now need to file that down using the needle file. In order to get my needle file in, I've got to break this part of the box away here. So I can use a screwdriver in order to break out the inner lip. Okay, like so. And obviously now I can take my needle file and I can work away at that edge there. Okay, let's take our needle file and we'll work this line down so it's closer to where we marked with the hacksaw. Preferably we would have had a smaller pair of pliers that perhaps could have got us a fraction deeper in there. Unfortunately at college all our pliers are really large, so I'm going to take a needle file and we're going to have to work that down until it's down to the level where we've made the cut and therefore a cable can be facilitated. So we're working it away with our needle file and we're bringing that line down and we'll bring it down to this level here. So I'm going to work on this and I'll show you when I'm done. So what we can see is I've worked it down to the line of where I've cut it, just finishing off, making sure it's some nice smooth edges. And we can see later on in the first fix when the cable is inserted, we're going to have a reasonable fitting around the actual cable itself. The IP rating will not be on the top of this enclosure IP4X, so there still will be accessible for objects that are greater than 1mm. So we're going to end up having to put a silicone sealant in here to return the IP rating to its correct value. We'll do that later on. So at the moment that box is now ready to be secured to, in this case, our wooden surface. So what we're going to do now is we're going to replace this box with the hole that's too large. We know when the cable goes in there, the IP rating is going to be miles off IP4X. So we're going to take this one away and we're going to replace it with the one I've just cut out, which obviously has a hole that better facilitates the cable and will make it easier to return the IP rating down. First time we've fixed a wooden board, I've already got four of my five accessories down. We're going to use the bradawl to make a hole by pushing it against the wood. We're going to be using 3/4 inch number 8 countersunk screws. It's a plastic box, it has a countersunk recess at college, so we're using countersunk screws. We're also going to use the two outside fixing points. I'll break them through for you to show you what they are, the two outside ones. One of them is a slightly larger screw fixing, so it gives us the ability to adjust if we don't quite get it level. So our box goes down, take our bradawl, and we position it onto the board to start a hole. Take our posi drive screw, drop it into the hole that we've already started, and we'll tighten up one of them onto the wooden board. 3/4 inch screws won't go through the board. Take our other one, take our bradawl, start the position of our hole into the wood, and then we go again with a posi screw. We get it down, we need to make sure that it's the distance that we discussed between our boxes and that we're level at the top. This is all about using, first time we've used a bradawl, and we're screwing a box down correctly onto a wooden surface using countersunk screws, but only after we've cut out correctly a hole in the top surface in order that we reduce the need to fill the gap with a silicon sealant by making a lot tighter hole in the top.
So here we have a completed installation with a cable entering the top of an electrical enclosure, and we can see the electrical contractor, in this case me at college, I have reinstated the IP rating by putting on a white silicon sealant. It could have been clear, and we can see by entering an object on the top surface, I cannot get it in there. In this case, this is a piece of stripped cable. Okay, so I can't get it in the top electrical enclosure. Therefore, I've returned the IP rating to at least IP4X. Objects exceeding 1 millimeter cannot enter the top of this electrical enclosure. I hope this has been some help.